So then guys, we've just had the announcement of the brand new 14 and 16 inch MacBook Pros with the M2 Pro and the M2 Max chipset. However, with the last generation 14 inch MacBook Pro with the M1 Pro chipset, how does it compare to the brand new M2 Pro chipset in a 14 inch body? Well, today, what I'm going to do for you, I'm going to do a comparison. I'm going to do the brand new MacBook Pro M2 Pro versus the MacBook Pro M1 Pro in this review of specs comparison for you. And the best way to get started is show some numbers. So let's get started. So here we are then. We have the brand new MacBook Pro 14 inch M2 Pro on the left side and the MacBook Pro 14 inch M1 Pro from 2021. Today I'm going to be reviewing the standard M2 Pro and the M1 Pro chipset, not the binned version. So starting off then, what we have is we have the display type. So the display technology in both of these MacBook Pros are identical. The mini LED ProMotion display first debuted on the 12.9 inch iPad Pro in 2021, and then later on that year it came to the 14 and to the 16 inch MacBook Pros. So both of these models have the exact same screen inside them. What is the mini LED ProMotion display? The screen size of this 14 inch isn't exactly 14 inches, it's actually 14.2 inches. And the main reason is it houses up that little notch at the top, and that's where that extra 0.2 of an inch comes into play, basically, because of that notch in the middle, what houses the webcam or the FaceTime camera, what I'll talk a little bit further on into this video. But the actual screen resolutions on both of these MacBook Pros are identical, and that resolution is 3024 by 1964. Well, it's a fantastic resolution for a MacBook or any laptop this size, to be honest. Then what that basically sort of converts to is pixels per inch. And basically, both of these MacBook Pros have the exact same pixels per inch, or PPI, what is 254, and which coincidentally is also the exact same of pixels per inch what you get on the 16-inch MacBook Pro 2 with the mini LED display. So they're exactly the same, the pixels per inch, 254 of them. Next of all, we actually have the display refresh rate. So we have a 120 hertz refresh rate. That's that ProMotion display, and that's on both of these MacBook Pros. So the display can go up to 120 hertz, which is really quite fantastic for doing all sort of your editing and also maybe a little bit of gaming too, if you wanted to do that on the MacBook Pro. The brightness as well is exactly the same on both of these MacBook Pros, the 14 inch, and it's 1000 nits. So basically this means if you've got light coming in onto your screen, if you're outdoors for example, and you've got bright light hitting onto your screen, the 1000 nits will help you definitely out there. So yeah, it's really good to see that. And also both of these displays also have True Tone technology inside them. Moving on to the processor and CPU, and this is where the biggest change probably happens the most in the 14 inch MacBook Pros. So right now we have the M1 Pro, this is the first one I want to talk about, and the 14 inch model, the M1 Pro, the normal chipset has a 10 core CPU. And in that 10 core CPU, what we actually have is actually we have 2 efficiency cores and 8 performance cores. And then we've also got the GPU, the graphics inside that, and that goes up to 16 cores inside that for the GPU. But you can also get the binned version of the M1 Pro, and that comes with an 8 core CPU, and that comes with 2 efficiency cores, 6 performance cores, and also the GPU only has 14 GPU cores inside it. But the MacBook Pro 14 inch M2 Pro is a different story. This time, what you actually have for the standard M2 Pro chipset is actually you have a 12 core CPU, and this is 2 efficiency cores, and then also this is now 10 sort of performance cores inside. Was absolutely remarkable. And then also for the GPU, you can go up to a 19 core GPU, was also really, really fantastic. But you can also pick the binned version of the M2 Pro, and this comes with a 10 core CPU, and again this has 2 efficiency cores, 8 performance cores, and then you also can pick a 16 core GPU with that, the binned version on this. So you can see here then, for either the binned version or the normal version of the M2 Pro over the M1 Pro, you'll definitely be getting more cores, and you'll see why this is important a bit more later on. But next of all, let's move on to the RAM amounts. Now, RAM amounts for the M2 Pro and the M1 Pro, the choices are exactly the same. You can either pick 16 gigabytes or 32 gigabytes of RAM. Unfortunately, you cannot pick any more RAM, like 24 gigabytes of RAM, like what you can do with the MacBook Air, or you can do that with the M2 MacBook Pro. Well, it's a little bit unusual, in my opinion, that that option isn't there. But anyway, those are the choices that you have got for that. Then also, we have the storage amounts. Now, storage amounts are exactly the same as last time with the M1 Pro 14 inch. You can choose from 512 gigabytes all the way to up to 8 terabytes with your M1 Pro or the M2 Pro chipset. And just in case you're wondering, for Geekbench 5 multi-core score, and this is on the normal M1 Pro, not the binned version, and also the normal M2 Pro, again, not the binned version, the MacBook Pro M1 Pro with the 14 inch comes in at 12,037, but the new M2 Pro normal version comes in at 13,728. And remember, Apple claiming up to 20% more performance on the M2 Pro over the M1 Pro. Then moving on, we do have ports. So the ports wise, they are very, very similar. We have 3x USB-C ports, what are Thunderbolt 4 ports and USB 4 ports on that. So that's really, really cool. We still have the MagSafe 3 port as well, which is really, really good. But HDMI is available on both these machines, except for you can also get up to 8K HDMI on the M2 Pro, what is really, really fantastic to see. We also do have the SDXE card slot as well, so the SD card slot, so that's really good to have that. And then moving on to operating system, both of these machines can run the latest macOS 13 Ventura, and most likely the M2 Pro will probably be able to support operating systems probably for the next, say, 5 to 6 years, whereas probably the M1 Pro probably about the next 4 to 5 years instead. So there is a bit of a difference there, mainly because obviously this version of the M2 Pro has come out in 2023 and the M1 Pro came out in 2021, the end of that year. Moving on then to battery life. So battery life has changed ever so slightly. So with the MacBook Pro 14 inch M1 Pro, you could get up to 17 hours of battery life, but now with the 14 inch M2 Pro, you can get up to 18 hours. So this basically means Apple have made their chipset a little bit more efficient in the M2 Pro. But if you were to do sort of hardcore video editing or photo editing, you probably wouldn't notice the difference really in sort of battery life. This is literally pushing the MacBooks out to their extreme with really low brightness and not pushing out the MacBooks to do heavy tasks that you'll probably actually gain this extra hour, but that's about it really. For charging wattage, it's up to 96 watts on the M1 Pro and the M2 Pro. It's exactly the same. It's a little less if you get the binned version. I think it's 69 watts on that one. But for the normal M1 Pro and the normal M2 Pro, it is 96 watts. And again, it's a MagSafe charger to charge this up. The actual weight of these MacBook Pros are exactly the same again. They both weigh 1.5 kilograms, except for I would say that if you did have a number next to that 5 of the 1.5, the M2 Pro is ever so slightly heavier in like a couple of grams, but you would not notice it at all. It's really, really hard to actually tell the difference between both of these models. But obviously, as it's a slightly bigger chipset, the M2 Pro, it's slightly more understanding why. Then we also have got the stereo speakers. Both of these MacBook Pros have the exact same speaker sets inside them, and they're also spatial audio for their stereo speaker set. Then moving on to Wi-Fi, things change ever so slightly here. So the MacBook Pro 14 inch M2 Pro actually has Wi-Fi 6E, whereas the MacBook Pro 14 inch M1 Pro actually only has Wi-Fi 6. So yeah, it has a slightly newer technology inside it. Then let's talk about the price. And this is the most interesting thing. So basically the prices of both of these MacBooks are exactly the same price as of when they were launched. With the 16-inch MacBook Pros, though, if you got yourself the M1 Max chipset inside it, funny enough, it does actually cost $200 more. But here, with the binned M1 Pro and the binned M2 Pro, they start out at $1,999, what is exactly the same price. So with the MacBook Pro 14-inch M2 Pro, it is a really, really good deal, because even if you pick the binned version of the M2 Pro over the M1 Pro, you will definitely get at least two more GPU cores and two more CPU cores, and plus those cores are also clocked even faster, and also the MacBook Pro is even more efficient as well, as you've seen, as I've talked about in this comparison. So it's really good to actually get that price, so I'm really, really happy with that, that Apple have done that, and that is for the 512GB model. The colours are exactly the same again. You get yourself a sort of a grey, and what is the space grey, and there's also the silver colour too. And then finally, what new MacBook are you planning to buy this year? Will it be one of these new MacBook Pros with the M2 Pro, or maybe you might hunt down an M1 Pro? Well, there we have it, folks. As you can see, apart from mainly the actual chipset and some enhancements to RAM and other bits and pieces like that underneath the hood, overall, the brand new 14-inch MacBook Pro isn't that much different to the last generation with the M1 Pro inside it. Yes, you are getting a faster chipset and bits and pieces like that, but overall in features and abilities, there isn't that much difference. For example, you still get the mini LED display, you still get all the same ports, it's still the same design. And right now, you can pick up the 14-inch MacBook Pro with an M1 Pro chipset inside it with some really good deals out there, so do look out for them. But if you do want the best of the best, it is definitely recommended to go for the M2 Pro MacBook Pro 14-inch, because at the end of the day, it is world-class and it is the best. Well guys, there is the comparison for you of the initial specs at this stage. I hope you've enjoyed it. And also guys, if you have enjoyed watching this video, please do press the like button. And also, if you want to hear the latest Apple news reviews and comparisons just like this one, please make sure you subscribe to this channel and also hit that notification bell. Until next time guys, I will see you really soon. Take care. Bye bye.